Soul genetics, healing, scenarios. Please make comments on the video unless it's too personal and set up PMs so we can share all awareness with everyone. And as always, any hateful comments will be deleted and your channel blocked. My guys asked me to make another video in regards to soul genetics and how they do create problems in our lives or issues or not. Let me tell you, okay, I told you already I've had a lot of metaphysical background in past lives. So when you want something done, who are you going to go to? They're not going to come to me if they need an artwork done because I'm not an artist, but I am creative. They're going to search the person that has the ability to do what they need done in order to get a job done, okay? That's part of who we are. It's the emotional being of who we are. It's what makes us who we are today. It is the totality of each individual is our soul. And what's in that soul guides us, helps us, or hinders us. And hinders us meaning the soul genetics can also have things that we carry over from past lifetimes. And you can meditate and go into these past lifetimes like my guide did to me, helping me to understand why I had certain things happening to me in my life. So that he also showed me how I could eradicate those emotions within my soul. How I could look at them and honor them and walk away from them. I worked with other people that have had problems in their soul, and I say, just hang in there for a few more years. If you can, it'll be fine. I found other people that have had attachments to them, you know, like, oh yeah, mom had that disease, so I have it and I'm dying and she died and that kind of thing. And I'm thinking, okay, where's mom? You know, maybe she's attached to you. There's just so many things when it comes to healing, and the soul genetics is one of the biggest things. You have a fear of things and you don't know why. You have a disease in your family, but nobody else does. You have an issue with emotional trauma. Nobody else has felt like that. That's when you start asking yourself, why? Why do I have these issues, but nobody else has had these issues? Why am I having this health problem, but nobody else in my family has this health problem? I mean, we have some generic things, okay? But this is basically what my guides had said to someone a long time ago in regards to, why children, have problems and stuff like that. Big issue for me because I love children and I really don't think they should be having any issues. But it opens up the door to understand that sometimes it's not just the current genetic of the human being because of the family that they are into. And that's always that possibility. It also could be a genetic in the soul. Something that you have carried over with you that is feeding that brain and that body over and over and over again. And I told him, I've learned that it could be a number of things. And again, this is all generalization because everyone's individual and you have to investigate each individual on an individual basis, obviously. I said, it's a diseased soul brought over from a past or several past lifetimes. That kind of thing may take some time to disease the body and mind of the now. Two, it is a psychic attack, infant stage, or even throughout life. Some things that happen in my case that can create issues where it makes the doctor scratch their head in perplexity, not knowing what it is. And this happened to me a few times, many times. Can you imagine what would happen if Saddam Hussein came back into the body of an infant and everyone was sending negativity or hate to that body of that infant? Without the awareness that this being has now been incarnated into a body and is now being bombarded with hate. I'll give you, for instance, I don't say that Johnny is got a spirit that is being attacked because of meanness. I think she's just a blessed being and they're not allowing her truth. But again, that's another scenario of why people can have mental or physical issues. All the negativity and hate that would be projected to the infant because people don't have any awareness of what they are doing, can cause an issue. Three, it is a genetic flaw created in the child by its parents' ancestors' genetics. Okay, so yes, you can have a genetic flaw in the family or a situation that can create this. and it can be a follow down gene. That's just another scenario. My guide said until the genetics or DNA of a person is taken before and after a situation, how are you going to know? In other words, my mom had breast cancer. Say they take my genetics when I'm an infant and they say your DNA does not expose you to that kind of scenario. But then my mom passes away. And then I go and have another DNA test and they say, oh yeah, you're very susceptible now to it. Is my mother attached to me? This is the kind of questions that I ask. I told you I'm a questioner. Now, it is the disease or drugs that the parents have currently passed on to the infant. So in other words, it could be something that's going on with the parent because they developed something, and it may not be some genetic thing that's going on. It may be something that they just did to themselves, like drugs, and they're passing that on to the infant as well. Let's see. Let me see what else did they say. I think that's basically it, but you have to understand there's so many scenarios of what can happen to a person's body and mind based on the genetics of the family and the genetics of the soul. If you're having issues with your life because of health, ask yourself, did Great Aunt Sarah have the same thing? And if so, where's Great Aunt Sarah now? Or is this in my soul? Did I have a lot of issues in past lifetimes from plagues or diseases that is now coming at me and attacking me in this lifetime because of what I have in my soul? You've seen my soul videos. You know things can happen. All I'm saying is the power of healing comes from the power of knowing. And I just wanted to share that. They just wanted me to share that with you and have been wanting to for a long time. But my thing was, I believe that you have to go to first grade before you can go to second and third and fourth and fifth. I've been spending almost a year explaining things to you in videos about what goes on out there and what can go on within you. And these soul videos that I've been doing is another way for them to have you understand about your soul so that you can better take care of yourself. In other words, the expression goes, to know you is to love you. You see, I know more about you than you know of yourselves. And that's why I'm doing this for you. So, hope you enjoyed it. Hugs and peace. Bye-bye now.